After almost a year of renovations, it's finally time to start furnishing the chapter house. We previously unloaded a truck full of decor, and now it is time to turn this place into a guest house. Meanwhile, at the cafe, we've completed the electrical rough-in, our first change order, and the insulation, just in time for the drywall guys to start working their magic. The push is on to complete both of these projects in time for the summer rush of tourists. Okay, so I know you guys have been seeing as we've kind of been like picking things up and bringing things in. This pile behind us has grown and grown and grown.
Almost a full house full.
Yeah.
Almost.
And it's a little bit overwhelming, I think, because it's like, where do we even start with this?
For me, it's definitely overwhelming. Like, if you gave me a lot for the drawing, I wouldn't feel overwhelmed for building the house.
Right.
I would not.
Yeah.
This right here, it's like, it's where I lean and put a lot of my confidence, take it off myself and put it on you, 100%.
That's what I'm here for.
Yes.
I've got it all under control. So what I'm thinking the best course of action at this point is, since all the little stuff is out of here, the mattresses to those bedrooms, this smaller mattress to the loft. These are little end tables for the living room couch area. Yep. Here's bar stools for over there in the kitchen. So it's really not as bad as it looks. This is another one of these chairs that's gonna be in this area. Some of these are mirrors for bathrooms. Wait, are you alive?
I'm alive.
Okay.
Every time we moved, she's unpacked an entire house in one day. That's what she's known for. So I have a good team player here to get this job done.
I will stay up all night long until that house is unpacked.
Yes.
And that's exactly what we're going to do today. I'm just kidding.
Thank God. I'm like, what? That wasn't part of the plan.
No worries. We had a little espresso shot before we headed over here.
Yes.
So we are ready to rock and roll. Mm-hmm. The plan is start unboxing. Let's get things put in the specific rooms that they need to go in so that we have some actual space to work with. We can see what we're working with. And we are going to furnish and decorate this house. Thank you for helping. How you doing?
I'm okay. But it's very stressful for me.
Are you serious?
Yes.
You built our house. But like furnishing a house is stressful?
It's not that bad. Just there's no fun in this, you know?
Oh my gosh, this is so much fun. What are you talking about? Do you see all those boxes right here that are begging for you to put together?
Yes. What I don't want to do.
None of it is IKEA furniture.
It might as well be. You know?
It's going to be very quick.
I hope so.
Yeah.
We're moving right along, if you guys can't tell.
Yeah. We're like probably about one time lapse away from having a couch sitting area that you can relax on.
And so, once that happens, I'm taking a rest.
But first, you're building furniture. You will survive.
I know.
Hey, remember Josh? You're the one who sold this disheveled house and wanted to do this in the first place.
I saw it and I knew it had tons of potential. I just knew it.
Yes. And now we're about to make it shine. Okay?
One, two, three. We're gonna go, girl.
What you gonna say? How you gonna feel at the end of the day? Do you ever wonder if it ever gets old? Does all that glitter leave you shining like gold? So guys, I think we're starting to wear down.
Yeah, I've been telling myself, let's do one more thing. I got about an hour and a half to go.
This really is the last piece though, like for now.
Yeah, we'll come back. We'll get here early one morning and just bang everything else out. Take all the cardboard, throw it in the dump trailer and roll.
I agree.
And be done.
And be done.
Now, the only thing we're waiting for is a hot tub. And by my calculations, it'll be here in about 2.5 weeks.
Perfect.
I know, right?
Thank you.
Yeah. It's unique, you know?
So much character.
A lot of texture, a lot of character. You have an amazing view out those windows too.
Mountains.
I know.
This house has come a long way from its days of exterior growth, rotting walls, and crazy layout. It now feels like home. Even though it's not really our home, it will be a home to those guests who come to enjoy the beauty that West Virginia has to offer. This home will now continue to live on for years to come, restored now to be a beautiful little retreat in the mountains, made for travelers making memories throughout all the seasons of the year. We have more work to do here, but our cafe renovation is calling our name and reminding us that we need to keep up with the other trades in order to stay on schedule.
We're at the cafe today. I have to build a wall in the kitchen so the plumber can rough in all of his plumbing. It's gonna be for a hand sink so we can wash our hands while we're cooking and doing our thing. I also need to go outside. I have some exterior work I need to take care of. Next step for all electrical in this building is to upgrade the service. So we gotta mount our meter, a couple troughs, a 400 amp disconnect, and we gotta pop into the building. Already have the hose. Cord road, so we're ready to rock and roll. I'm gonna need your help on this one. Oof, that. So the meter's up, I got the 400 amp disconnect up, all the troughing is up. I gotta pop up on the top of that trough and come into the building, which is gonna feed the panels. I'm still waiting on a 3-inch hub to come out top of this. Excuse me.
Romney's getting a little wild.
Getting wilder now. A 3-inch hub, I'm waiting on that to come out on top of this with a 3-inch pipe that goes up to the weatherhead and where the power cone is going to tie into. We're going to finish the pipes up, then we have a bunch of books that keep getting delivered to the cafe. We're going to get those things moved over to the other building. So Brad sent us this book right here, his most perfect name. It's called Chapter House. And in the note that he wrote us, he goes, he knows the name of the house, it's called the Chapter House. He said he can only think of one book for that house, and it's the book called Chapter House.
So perfect. We got some really good news, and that's that the hot tub is actually arriving here at the Chapter House today, a lot earlier than we were expecting. So we're not completely prepared, but it's okay. We're going to get caught up and make it work. And while we wait for the delivery to get here, we figured we would try to tackle another room.
So we're in the master bedroom on the second floor. If you guys remember, this was actually like a storage area with a lot of shelving up top with no bathroom up here, no windows. We added both, the wall behind me closed everything off and turned it into a master bedroom. And it was a real treat doing this too. The big issue was trying to get this wall built. Building the wall wasn't the issue, just having enough space to make this entire thing work, because that entire area out here is all floating. We couldn't go out that way and close the balcony or the loft off and put a wall there. So we only had one spot where we can put a wall, and it fits just enough for a queen size bed. But once it's all said and done, it's gonna be nice and cozy in here. And that's a key word for small. Disaster strikes. See, we built the wrong bed frame in the first place. This one goes downstairs. The one we got for the headboard actually came with the headboard, and we realized that we ordered it weeks ago, and we just forgot.
Yeah.
But there's still not much space. Once we get everything built, I might have to show you guys the proper way, once the mattress is on here, to get to the bathroom from here. One of those jump, duck, tuck, and roll things.
So we knew that this was going to be an issue coming down the line when we built the bedroom up here.
Yes.
But the thing was, if you're going to have a bedroom up here, do you want to be making people like go downstairs to go to the bathroom like in the middle of the night? No, you want to have a bathroom up here and there's not much space. So it's like a little bit of a tight squeeze coming down this way at the foot of the bed. But you can't turn the bed that way because the bathroom door is over there. And if you turn the bed that way,
it's still got minimal space coming through.
Yeah.
It's going to be a jump, duck, tuck, and roll.
So you come here, you relax, you get a little bit of exercise, like getting in and out and around the bed, and then yes. You just go soothe your sore muscles in the hot tub.
Yes.
The hot tub's here.
The hot tub's here?
Yeah. Here.
So the hot tub itself is 700 pounds, at least with a pallet. It sits, I think, 5 people. So this is gonna be awesome to have over next to the deck, looking at that amazing view. Hopefully it snows.
Oh yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So the hot tubs are the best when it's snowing outside.
I agree, but even on a day like this where it's chilly but it's bright green with all the bloomed dogwoods out here, it'd be amazing to get in.
I know.
We just need a concrete pad.
Yes. I went bad at all. Whew. So what we can do, I know it's 700 pounds, but it slides fairly easy on that. We can take it and just put probably 4x4x12 feet, make a little row of it, we slide it, and hopscotch, and keep pushing all the way up and around. Probably the boys give us a hand, but it's not a big deal. You know what I mean? So when we do the concrete, we'll do 8 foot wide, and it'll stick out a little bit past on the backside, but this front portion right here, we're gonna want probably 2 feet extra for the steps and you can stand on.
Yeah.
Versus walking the mud.
Oh yeah.
You know? Easy. I'm excited.
I'm excited too.
And now back to the bedroom drama. So we got the bed, proper bed, like frame, I guess, and headboard in here and it looks so nice. It really fits the room. We have the mattress in.
It's tight, but you can squeeze by.
And I think it's worth it to leave it set up the way that it is.
Yeah.
Guests will give us feedback. Some people probably have a problem with it. Some people won't.
This is what's going to happen. They're going to give us feedback. It's too tight to squeeze through. The bed is. But guess what? The sleep's going to make up for it because the mattress is top notch.
That's definitely true. Yeah. So do you want to demonstrate the proper way to get through the bedroom, Josh, from the door right here to the bathroom right there?
Yeah.
Hit it, baby.
Jump, tuck, and roll. Just like that.
It's really not that bad, I promise. No, look.
All you really have to do is the shimmy.
We can do this. You know?
It's not that bad.
It's not that bad.
And it looks beautiful.
I mean, I think if we do move it, it's going to mess the throw, the look of the room. And plus, it's going to be just tight.
Yeah.
So we'll just leave it. And we'll deal with it. You know, we have a few bad comments, whatever.
Nothing we're not used to.
Yeah.
We're gonna have some happy guests. Let's put it that way.
It's like when you go to a hotel, the bed's never good enough.
But when you come here, it's perfect.
Because the Helix, that's why. Oh, goodness. That feels good, dude. I'm not lying. Oof, da. Gonna spend that tonight or what?
So we don't have everything for this room. We're still missing some pillows, like decor, and stuff like that. We haven't touched the bathroom.
No.
Last shower doors need to go in.
We're taking it a step at a time.
We are.
We're getting close.
And we've made a little bit more progress.
Yes.
So it's a good deal.
We got concrete pour here. Aren't you excited?
Yeah, I am.
Asking me for the pad for the hot tub.
Concrete is never ending, ever.
Another concrete day.
Yay.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Let's go, Mino. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
I do I know that this is the best night ever.
You say that every day.
It's a good day.
No!
Your official initiation into
the crow.
Hi.
Right. Frankie.
Oh my god.
Lily doesn't know what it is. She's like, this isn't a bottle. Take a nibble. Leon promises you'll like him.
Just like Leon a few years ago.
Yeah.
You hear the creek? It's roaring, girl.
Sounds beautiful. You hear the summer bugs?
Yeah.
That's my favorite.
Right?
Yeah.
I can creep the summer bugs. It's always good.
Yeah.
It's perfect temperature. It's cool. It's not hot, obviously. It's not humid. It's hoodie weather with a fire.
Summer is coming.
It's coming.
That's what it is.
Next up's lightning bugs.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Can't wait for that. Uh-huh. Those are always nice. Yeah.